quickly going to pull out some of the elements of this story structure. Classic methodology here, as we'll see in a second. Let's go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing and filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure as a loop. The classic, we describe the classic beginning and ending as a state of perfection, which in essence is a loss, becomes a state of imperfection, the loss phase, the limitations phase, and the process of returning to it is undergone. You can start there, or somewhere in between. If you do that, the events that tend to be referenced at later stages, as in this story. Most stories end with some form of state of perfection, as in this one. If you don't want to do that, if you want to end with imperfection or some combination, that's almost irrelevant. The process is always the same. So, we're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, the various arcs, psychological journey. We're always going to have a physical journey, and we're always moving through new worlds, which really are physical manifestations of new psychological states and new versions of the self. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated that tell you what tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire, how to construct those sequences. So for example, if that's the ordinary world, we know it's a state of protection, repression, fear of X, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. When you're here, you're not able to return. You have to go forward, grow, learn, mature, let go of the older limitations, in essence, and versions of your older self come all the way around until you're ready to return. So that's basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework all successful stories are based around. I go over that in great detail in the 2100 stage here is journey transformation, movement through new worlds and states, which you can purchase off the website. So let's get rid of that. Let's draw another loop so we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle would suggest. So state of perfection lost in a very classical way, actually, quite often represented as the Garden of Eden. So the Garden of Eden is lost. Symbolism includes fertility, so it's fertile, it's lost. Ultimately, the Garden of Eden is returned to, and we see that here, and fertility returns, so we see that here also in fruits appearing, the coconuts are no longer dead, fish appear, and so on. Damage done in a number of ways, so classically it's done, one of the methods is you go into a cave, you pull out a tangible, and that, in essence, opens Pandora's Brox, brings out about the damage, and that's what happens here. Maui goes in, takes Tafiti's heart, and it's lost. Maui is doing that as a result of his own limitations. As a consequence, also, we have lost who we were, who you are. The islanders were voyagers, but they've lost that. And it's caused all sorts of issues and limitations. So with Moana's father, he did try and go beyond the reef, but his best friend died, and so his own limitations were established. So we're going to return to the Garden of Eden, we're going to return to fertility, but we're also going to rediscover who we were as we come round. And in essence, also, our self-belief was lost. And we're going to go and we're going to rediscover that too as we go around the cycle. We've got classic methodology again in the prophecy, so very much like the Jesus story, it's prophesied that a chosen one will appear and right the wrong, and here we have Moana, who is the chosen one. The sea chooses her, and she will go about returning us to our state of perfection. She embarks on the journey at the on the cusp of maturity, so it's a metaphor for growing up, the stories. We meet her in the ordinary world. She's a willing hero as an ordinary self, as her ordinary self, she lacks, she has these limitations, so she doesn't know who she is, and she lacks self-belief. But she's a willing hero, willing to go beyond the reef, and she's held back. So she's got the call, and she, there's the refusal, and the refusal given, in essence, by a parental figure who is an interdictor holding her back. So very much like Star Wars, A New Hope, Luke wants to go, but Uncle Owen is holding him back. Ultimately, she's forced out, so the coconuts are dying, the fish are dying, we need to go beyond the reef in order to right the wrong, restore fertility, etc., fulfill the prophecy, fulfill one's own destiny. We go past, we meet our supernatural aid, so this is Grandma, and Grandma gives us a magical gift, shows us who we were voyagers, and then there's the encouragement to go onto that journey and rediscover who we were. So she rushes to Dad and says, "Let's, you know, this is who we were, let's go and rediscover that." Grandma dies, so death symbolism there, symbolizing death of the old estate. We see that again in lots of movies, so for example, Gladiator, there's death at this stage. And ultimately, she gets past all of those refusals and she goes on to that journey. So she crosses past the reef, again, the reef being the furthermost point you know, at the edge of the ordinary world, very much like Fellowship of the Rings, where Frodo says, "This is the furthest I've been past the Shire." So we're reaching the borders of our ordinary world and our ordinary existence and our ordinary self. In our first threshold, we've got a number of things to do. We've got a little task or a quest, if you want. That is to find, in this story, Maui. So we achieve that then. First threshold separation is him leaving on the journey also. He doesn't want to take her or Moana with him, and she escapes from that cave, and that in essence is the beginning of the physical separation, beginning away from her, pulling away from her older self, and beginning to right these wrongs and beginning to develop self-belief. So we go into our deeper journey. There's again refusals there, notably by Maui. And that's part and parcel of wanting to be pulled back. We have, through our own trials, we have a reversing around. So she's escaped from the cave on her own. She gets the heart back from those coconut pirates on her own. All the way around to Susan Tangible Sword, where, in effect, she gets Maui's a magical fish hook from the crab. This is done again in a classical way, so normally you go into the tallest tower or the deepest dungeon, and here we have both. So they're climbing the tower and then going down into the deepest dungeon. We have various symbols appear here. Here we've got a crab, that's not unusual. We tend to have some sort of crab, turtle-like, sea-like creature. You can see that in The Neverending Story, for example. Deers are also common. Certain symbolisms appear here, and there's a certain methodology to acquiring the sword, which we see, and also acquiring the sword symbolizes a number of things, and here we can see that the crab has self-belief and is who he is. So you know, he wants to be shiny, etc., and so forth. Then we go into our underworld phases, lots of death symbolism here, triggered by Maui saying, "Oh, I can't even you know, defeat the crab, how am I going to defeat Takar in the atonement? We're doomed, he can't transform you know, in the way that he used to with the magical hook. We're on a night sea journey, so we're on our voyage, but you know, this is taking place at night." This is when we also learn our lesson. So this is where Maui relates his past. He was doing it to get approval from humans. And in essence, she's saying that you don't need approval from the gods or humans. You, you know, just be yourself. And in essence, learning the lesson herself. Coming all the way around to atonement. So we finally have achieved the boom. So the quest has been to find Maui, get the fish hook, deliver him to Takar, and then return the stone. So she does that. She's also, the intangible boon is, for example, she's discovered here who she is, and that is demonstrated through her being a sailor. So we benchmark early on that she can't sail very well, we benchmark it later, and by the time we get here, she has learned to sail, and that is a demonstrative of her becoming a voyager again. Into our final section, we complete the self-belief arc. So we've got the disappearance of our supernatural aids. They tend to dissolve away and then return later. So we've got Maui disappearing, the chicken being hidden away. We've got a grandmother appearing again and triggering that final achievement of self-belief. Very similar to the Wizard of Oz here. So originally in the Wizard of Oz, you meet Glenda there, and then she comes back and gives that final trigger to Dorothy and says, you know, you always had the power within you, it's just you didn't know it or you had to learn it. So same sort of thing happening here. It's about self-belief. And then going alone to restore the heart and battle Takar in the final conflict on her own. She doesn't need help anymore. Ultimately doing that, returning us to our state of affection. So the Garden of Eden reappears again, and fertility reappears again. We've got our magical gifts or rewards, very much like the Wizard of Oz, where, you know, you get a brain, a heart, so on. And here you get your magical fish hook, you get your boat, and then you return in that final section home, and you give the gifts of the journey back to your countrymen so that we all can benefit from it, and then we, all the islanders then get past the reef and rediscover who they are and rediscover their self-belief. So that, a basic pull out of that story structure. I do these things just to show that they all do follow the process. I apologize that it gets messy, but there's no way you can really help that. There's just such small space there to put it all down. If you want a detailed deconstruction of this story, you can order it off the website. But once again, going through this process, I go over it in great detail on the 2100 stage here, Journey Transformation, Moving Through New Worlds and States, which you can purchase off the website.